boys and girls. Today we're going to draw our scuba man. So we're going to start with a big piece of paper. It's that nice watercolor paper. And we're going to fill the page. Now last class you guys designed either a warm color or a cool color underwater sea. The cool color used analogous colors, which are colors next to each other on the color wheel. The warm color did the same. So your warm color water uses warm analogous colors, like yellows and reds and orange. And then it uses cool color sea life inside of it, sea kelp. And then the cool color one will do the opposite. It'll have cool colors like purple, green, and blue. So today we're going to draw this scuba man. This is what it looks like, or she. And we're going to start by drawing it, and then we're going to paint it using tints and shades of blue. So a tint is adding white to a color, and a shade is adding black to a color. Now, when we draw, we want to make it big. I keep saying the word big because I don't want to see tiny little scuba people trying to float in the big wide ocean. So how we're going to do this is we're going to start, and I'll show you guys. I'm going to start with a pencil, and I'll draw it. So I can't see it. So I'm going to draw the pencil first, then I'll use a Sharpie. So I'll start with a little circle, and then a circle that goes around that little circle just outside. And I want to put a line underneath this. So I have a line and two circles. And then from that line, I'm going to draw one big circle. Now I know you can't see it. I understand. I'm about to get the marker out and show you. So, I'm going to grab my Sharpie. You're going to draw a pencil first, and you're going to go over with Sharpie. I'm going to draw a Sharpie just so you can see it. Before you use your Sharpie, make sure you raise your hand to let me see your drawing first so I can make sure it's big. So if it's too little, then I'll have to have you draw it again. So we're going to start, and we're going to draw our scuba man. So I'm drawing slow. I'm going to speed this up in a little bit, but how we do this is you draw one little circle and then a bigger circle, draw a line underneath, and then we're going to draw a big circle around our two circles that we just drew. And this is going to be the helmet. This is an old style helmet they used to use back before Jacques Cousteau invented the aqualung. Next, I'm going to draw a big half circle. This will be his shoulders and arms. So I just draw a big half circle. You don't want to go off the page, but you want to go close to the edge of the page. Next is going to be the body. So to draw the body, we're actually going to have to find where the armpits are. I know, we all have armpits. And then I want to draw kind of a rectangular shape. If you look at this, I make a rectangular shape, just like so. So I find the armpits. You guys are drawing a pencil, so if you mess up, you can erase. I've drawn a lot of scuba men recently, so I know how to do this, but practice makes perfect. So you're going to draw a line down. You see how it's looking like a rectangle. I messed up a little bit, but that's okay. Fix that line. If you mess up with your Sharpie, that's okay. We're going to be painting over it. The next step is I'm going to draw two quarter circles. So not a whole half circle, but like a quarter. A pie chart, quarter circle. And I want to make sure my line for my feet is even. It doesn't have to be perfectly even, but we don't want one leg longer than the other. So here comes the tricky part. I want to use my pencil because it is kind of tricky. We want to make sure the width of our legs, that means the wideness of our legs, are the same distance apart. And so we go up to kind of like a sharp point and then come back down. So I'm drawing on my own pencil just in case I mess up. Then I go up and I come down. Last part is I have to fix my scuba man's arms because now he doesn't have white full arms. So I'm gonna curve over. It's gonna be my hands. Just curve on over and then go attach it to the armpits. So curve over, attach it to the armpits. So that's pretty much my scuba man. I can then take it and add some details. And some details. Add a belt. Add some sleeves. You can get fancy with the belt. It's a little utility belt. Keeps all the scuba person's equipment on it. Also helps weigh them down. It has weights on it to keep the person from floating up. So they used to walk underwater in these. Next is our hand. Our hand, it's just four dashes, just four lines. Makes it look like our four fingers. If the thumb's tucked, you don't even see the thumb. But if you want to draw a thumb, it's a little loop. Just like I showed you. So it goes whoop and back. Whoop and back. Add some final touches, maybe some soles to my shoes, some tread. And that's pretty much how you draw your scuba man. Now let's talk about the paints. I've told you guys before, you need to wash your brush of one paint before you walk into somebody else's house. You don't walk into a new color's house with old color on your boots. Old color on your brush needs to be washed off. You see this? This is black and blue in the white paint. That should never happen, boys and girls. We all have to share these. So you need to make sure you wash your brush really, really, really good. And you wipe it clean. Just a little wipe. Before you stick your brush in a new cup of paint. Some of your paints might look like that. And I apologize. I don't have enough paint to go around and fix it all. So you're just going to have to stick your paintbrush somewhere where there's not black paint, blue paint. That's bad karma. Don't do that. So real quick, I want to show you drawing this again, but in a really fast mode. Maybe a little bit more detail on this too. But here I go. Draw two circles, a line. Draw a helmet. Draw the little things that attach the air pose to it. And then you want to draw the arms, armpits. Armpits are like a triangle. I'm sorry, the armpits come down like a rectangle. Make sure your feet are straight. Make sure your legs are the same width. Draw the hands back to the armpits. If you mess up, that's okay. You can fix it with the Sharpie. Add the weights. Add the thumbs. Add some bolts. Add some more detail to this one. You can do that too. It's up to you. Okay, so let's talk about tints and shades. Tints is when you add white. Shades is when you add black. I want to add some white to my scuba man's vest. And then when I touch it with just a little bit of black, make sure you're not globbing on any of the colors onto your paintbrush. Just be a little bit of paint on your brush. Just a tippity tip of paint on your brush. So you can mix white, mix black, and it gives you gray. So mix it together. Then I want to take some blue, just some regular blue, add some white to it, make it a light blue, add some black to it, make it kind of a navy blue. Mix those colors around. And then you just want to finish painting, adding different tints and shades of black and white and blue and grays. And that's all you have to worry about. And you finish that up. And once you're done, you're going to raise your hand, let me see it, and then we'll put it back on the drying rack and put your lids back on your paint and start cleaning up. Follow the cleanup procedures. And you got your scuba man. Next class, I'm going to show you guys how to cut this out and then make some collage fish to go on top of all of it, and we'll finish this project up. Awesome. Bye, guys.